Still morning. Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. I'm Norman from Groendel Primary. What can I say after such a long presentation of Dion and Dorian? But just a quick response to what happened between my partnership with me and Brian. You can go to the second one. There's the team, me, myself, Norman Africa. I'm the principal of Groendel Primary. We have a quintile one school, where learners are not paying any school fees. I was appointed in an acting capacity in 2005, but I was appointed as a permanent principal at the end of October that same year. And this my buddy, Brian Moore. Our first meeting was at a COP meeting. We haven't met before, but at that moment we shared a lot of personal stuff where we can relate it to. Can move to the second one, the next one. Go rectified. We have, there's our SWOT analysis. Our strength of the school is we have a good governance of school. The SEB are trained in roles and responsibilities, and we have a well established wellness team that looks after the care of learners, teachers, and parents. And one of our strengths is very dedicated personnel. And our weaknesses, there's no school fees. Our parents' involvement is lacking. Not all parents have reachable cell phones that influence good communication. At the beginning of every year, we renew our parents' cell phones. And when you phone them, there's an answering machine telling this number no more exist. And our weaknesses was our marketing of the school was very poor. And our threats, we have a lot of drug abuse after the legalization of marijuana. Now learners want to abuse their drugs, and we have a lot of problems around that. And because of the drug abuse, learners' behavior change. They are very violent towards each other and towards teachers. And teachers use teaching time to organize fundraising. That's the threats. And the opportunities, we have a lot of NGOs working with the school to develop the school. And the other opportunity is the Partners for Possibilities, where we were introduced to Brian and myself, and the opportunities that we created is a new marketing strategy that Brian will talk about later. Next one. Me, myself, and there's a lady that Brian introduced me to, Taryn, you will see later on the screen. We went and sit down when we had a lot of discussion about how to market the school. Then we came up with a lot of ideas. I think Brian will later on share this marketing strategy with all of you principals involved with the Partners for Possibilities. And one of the communications that we focus on is how we communicate around our meetings, our meetings, our journalists, funders, supporters, prospects, staff and parents, and any other outreach programs that happen at school, the second page. And there you can see what current funding we have, the current expenses and the fundraising ideas that we came up with, that Taryn put up together, and the needs analysis is to increase staff capacity, a computer room, a conference room, a classrooms, safety. And what stood out of this conversation was that the focus will be the marketing strategy and the safety of the school. There's the activities that we can report on. What we did is the learners marketing the school at Radio KC. That was a wonderful experience for them. And that was not a once-off happening at the radio station. That's an ongoing one. This morning we had a teacher on Radio KC talking about the schools and the matrix, writing exams, and wishing all well for the rest of the exams. And there you can see the grade 7 learners getting advice for high school. That project is one of our wellness projects that we created. We created a lot of leaders from high schools, and they came to the primary school to prepare the learners for the high school. And there's the team. There's Taryn in the middle with the ugly guys, Norman and Brian. She was the lady responsible for this wonderful project that we came up with. Next one. And there's the other activities. We had a culture evening. We had a major response from our parents. We had a big hall full to capacity that evening because of the marketing strategy. We had to decide for next year, we had to take that culture evening over 2 days. There's the two events on that cultural evening. We had also focused on anti-bullying. And there's one of our projects from the well-being project that the topic was cool to be kind, to create kind kids. And it was Brian introduced me to the owner of Pebble Alarms. We had CCTV cameras, but we expand the cameras, putting up 2 more cameras on very strategic corners that we can focus on surveilling what's happening on the school premises. At the previous cameras, there was no monitoring of what's happening on the school, but now the benefit of introducing me to Pebble Alarms and the owner is now, there was no burglaries, but there was very a lot of vandalism. Now the school is getting monitoring and they're giving us a response to what they see on the camera, and now we have a very safer school. And thank you, dear for Brian. There's our sponsors at the school. We have First Food First sponsoring salaries for teachers. Just it's not a lot, but giving us a share of there. Then we have the Wellcare Trust. Then we have Living Legends. It's guys giving us teachers for teaching us a life orientation, the physical education. And there's Babatani. Babatani is an organization established by school principals, where me and Lucy is board members of. Where all projects came from ECD to FET. Then we have the Click Foundation, that's a reading project, and there's Franco. Franco is its organization giving funds to schools. That organization was created because they wanted all the, what do you call it? The funds should be centralized in Franco's account and they will give it to schools. And then we have the My School project that Taryn and Ryan created us more introduction to further our funders through my village of my school. Then we got the Rupert's involved in the school, and then we have Future Kids, that's for software, for teaching CAPS in from grade 1 to 7. And then we have Green Suits, mathematics program sponsored by Green Suits. And then there's Frans Hoek, Information Center, Tourism. Yesterday, we got a commitment from Frans Hoek Tourism that they will support the school with any outings from grade 1 to 7, and they will support any fundraising events at the school. That's the sponsors of the school. Next one. Thank you very much. Maybe Brian will elaborate more on the marketing strategy.
Just to say, it's been an absolute privilege working with Norman. He is, without doubt, one of the most organized people I've ever met. And you know, learning just how complex the running of a school is, to have that sort of ability is a huge attribute. So, Norman, congratulations. The school is so slick and so organized. It's an example for everyone to see. Just briefly, The marketing strategy that we put together, it's multifaceted. And Dion, you said something very relevant. Out there, people want to give, but often they don't know where to give or what to give to. So the whole approach here was to make sure that we used every possible avenue to ensure that Kroondal Primary was sort of top of mind. And it is a multifaceted approach, and I won't go through all the components, but what I would ask, Jessica, perhaps if you could circulate the two slides, because it could act as a prompt to other people in determining ways of increasing market visibility and also funding. That's about all I need to say. Just once again, it's a privilege to work with Norman, and thank you very much for all you do for us.
Die volgende wil ik gewoon net graag in Afrikaans. Ik wil zeggen, baie dankie vir Jessica. Die eerste keer toe Jessica nou met vir my nader en ons gesels, toe wil ek nou net weet, Jessica, wat is Brian sy eerste taal? Dus jylle Engels, dan sê ek, oe jette. kom ek sê, die eerste ontmoeting met Brian was fantastisch. En dan wil ek net sê vir Merlin, ek weet nie of jy my verstaan nie, maar baie dankie dat jy vir Brian kon afgestaan het aan die school. Baie dankie vir jou, ne? Baie dankie, Brian. Okay. Nou, sien.